Hi, it's Sam the Old Man for Engineering Pokemon Go Part 3, and we're going to pick up right where we left off, at Parasect. And I went and I hatched an egg and I got a Paris with 82% IVs, so let's just evolve him right now. And hopefully we get Bug Bite Cross Poison. Morning coffee. I'll enjoy my morning coffee. But Bug Bite Cross Poison with the luck of the video. Come on. Give me something good. Give me something good. Bug Bite Cross Poison. Yay! There we go. Got it. I finished my Parasect now. Parasect. He'll be an 82. And he's a Defender 2. Cool. So let's adjust his name. Paris. Well, here, I've got to turn him back to nothing first. Nothing. Parasect 82. Defender 2. Well, that was a good way to start the morning. That luck of the video certainly helps. Now, our next one is Venomoth. So I've got the best attacker, Venomoth 85. Oh, I've got both. Venomoth 98. Oh, wow, that's a really good defender. So for now, unless I've got anything in the 90s, I don't think I need to do any more. I've got my Venomoths. They're done. Alright, Dugtrio. Yes, I need a lot here. So I've got some non-wonder attackers there. They've got the good moveset, but they're not wonders, which is fine for that one, which is 768, because it's sort of in that sweet spot for a gym attacking. But yeah, let's do some evolutions. Oh, there was a 91. Oh, and there's a 93. Oh, nice. Let's do 93 first. I've only got enough candy to do 3 evolutions, and I've got 3 movesets, so let's see how lucky we can get with the luck of the video. So, Mud Slap Earthquake is the first one I'm going for, or Mud Slap Mud Bomb. Let's just put a slash in there. So, I want either Mud Slap, Mud Bomb, and if I've got either of those moves, it's probably... Oh, no, the Sucker Punch Mud Bomb. Alright, there we go. So there's my defender, second defender. Okay, let's rename him. He's 93. So let's... Okay. Oh, yeah. Clear his name. Okay. Dugtrio 93. He's going to be D2. Dugtrio 93 D2. Alright, now we need the best attack and the best defense. Alright, second go. With the luck of the video. Come on, let's get Mud Slap Earthquake is what I want, and then Mud Slap Mud Bomb. Either way, I want Mud Slap to start. Come on, give me some mud slapping. Are you a mud slapper? No, you're not. You're a Sucker Punch Mud Bomb as well. Well, that's not the end of the world. I'll add him into the list here. So it becomes... 4, 5. He's 89 IVs. So let's rename him there. Dugtrio 89 is a defender 2. Dugtrio 89 defender 2 on the spreadsheet with Sucker Punch Mud Bomb. And paste. There we go. Okay. One last go. Hopefully I can get one more moveset for Dugtrio, but then I'm gonna have to go catch a bunch more so I can do some more evolutions. And this attacker here, that's not even a wonder. I'll just confirm that. Yeah. I'm just gonna transfer it right now. On my way to getting more candy. Alright, and we've got this 91 IV. Excellent. Let's evolve that one. And we want Mud Slap, Earthquake. Give me some ground moving earthquakes. Come on, Dugtrio. Be an earthquake mud slapper. Come on, you can do it. It's nothing. Nothing at all. And it's above 90, so I'm keeping it, unfortunately. Or fortunately, I don't know. I still need to get rid of 50 Pokemon to get down to that sort of 600 base. So I guess if I clear out some Mr. Mimes, which I'll do in a week or so when I get home to Kuala Lumpur. Alright, so that's my Dugtrios. Now we've got Persian, and I still have to get the best attacking moves. So let's see what we can do. Where's the best one? A 93 IV Meowth. Tons of Meowth candy from the Halloween event. So let's get going. Meow, meow. Start purring instead. Purr, purr. All right, scratch, play rough, or scratch, night slash is what we want. But either way, it's gonna be scratch. And it's nothing, and it's above 90. So I keep it. Next, we have this 87 IV Meowth. Evolve that one. And I definitely need a scratch. Come on. Be a scratcher. Cats like to scratch, don't they? Meowths like to scratch. Persians, in particular, they like to scratch. Is it a scratcher? No, it's a faint night slash, which is nothing, and it's below 90, so just transfer it right there. Well, there's some more space. Alright, an 86 IV one. Evolve that. Yes. We want scratch. Play rough. Scratch, play rough. That's a pretty decent move. Cats like to play rough. I certainly wouldn't want to play rough with a Persian. Scratch Power Gem. It's the third best attacker, and it's still an A grade, so I'll put it in here for now. My other attacker's a baby, so I may as well keep it. It is sort of in that sweet spot there. So let's rename you. You're 86 IV. Persian 86. And your attacker 3. That's Persian 86. Attacker 3. With Scratch Power Gem. Well, there's one attacker at least, and it's in the sweet spot, so that's all right. Next, we've got some. Well, there's the baby Meowth, but let's use this one here. 84% IV evolve, yes. Come on. Only got a couple more goes, and they're only just wonders, so not. I'll still be happy if I get the good attacking moves, and I'll keep them in that sweet spot. Feint, play rough. Feint attack, play rough. So there's another defender for me. So let's and add that in. It's a pretty hard this when there's so many combinations. You actually need to do quite a lot of evolutions to get all the movesets that you want. 84% IV, let's rename that. Persian 84 and a Defender 1. Okay, well, let rename that. Persian 84, Defender 1. Okay. With Faint Attack, Play Rough. Where's the Play Rough? There's the paste values. And we'll do one more for now on Meowth and see if we can get Scratch Play Rough. Evolve, yes. Come on, Meowth. Meowth. So once I've finished doing all my evolutions, then I'm going to make a list of the Pokemon that are going to be my top priorities to catch, and then a separate list for the ones that, you know, basically I don't need anymore. I've got all the movesets, I've got the candies. That way I know when I'm out and about which ones to use good Pokeballs on and which ones to just leave alone, because there's more Pokemon than there is Pokeballs now. Faint Attack, Power Gem, that is nothing, so you can be transferred right off. Alright, and that's Meowth done. Now the next one excites me, to get Gold Ducks. To get a Water Gun, Hydro Pump, Gold Duck. I got some, quite a lot here, so let's start. Oh, is that a baby Psyduck? Not quite. But let's start with this highest CP one and evolve it. Now, can we, so we want Water Gun Hydro Pump on a Gold Duck. And then we want Confusion Ice Beam for defending. So, what are we going to get with this Gold Duck? Yeah, there we go. A Defender. We have to rename him as well, so he becomes Gold Duck. Oh, clear the name. Okay, rename Gold Duck 87. Ah, cancel that. Gold Duck 87 D1. Okay. Gold Duck 87 D1. There we go. And now we just need an attacker. That would have been perfect CP for it to be a decent attacker. And you can see I've got an attacker, but it's not a wonder. And this 82 IV one with Water Gun Ice Beam, it's in that. Well, I think I might just transfer that because it's only 82 IVs. Let's just get rid of it. Yes. Because now, in theory, I could use my Defender 1-1 to attack if I had to. CP-wise, in terms of taking down a gym. But, what's next? I think I might leave that 69 CP-1 because I want... I'm probably not going to spend Stardust on Psyduck / Gold Duck now. I just don't have enough of it. Once I get back to Kuala Lumpur, I'm going to go grinding and get as much Stardust as I can. I'm going to try and get 1 million Stardust. Well, actually, first we'll do, like when I finish this, I'll do some power-ups of the Priority 1 Pokemons, which would probably take me down to almost no Stardust. And then, Water Gun Psychic. Alright, transfer. Pause the video there. Hello. And Rico. So let's evolve. An 80. Here's an 84. Evolve that. Yeah, so I'll power up my level 1 priority Pokemon, which will probably bring me down to almost no Stardust. And then I'll go on a Stardust collecting spree back in Kuala Lumpur and just see how long it takes to get 1 million Pokemon. I think I can do it in a week. Not a million Pokemon, a million Stardust. But it probably is close to a million Pokemon. I'm not sure how much Stardust you get each capture. Hey, Water Gun Hydro Pump, I did it. Gold. He's an 84 IV, so let's just rename him. Golduck, 84. Ah, did it again. Cancel the rename. Golduck, 84, attacking 1. And what's its CP? 501. It'll need some power-ups to get it to in that around at about 1,000 range. But that's alright. Golduck, 84, attacker 1. Nice. Very nice. There's my Golduck's done for now. Next, we're on to Mankey for Primeape. So I've only got one Primeape. I've seen one in wild, but I think it ran away. You have some pretty decent ones IV-wise, so 91. And I've got enough for the 3 evolutions, so that's exciting. 3 goes to get 2 moves. Evolve, yes. Either way, I want Low Kick as its primary move. And either Cross Chop for attacking or Low Sweep for defending. So Low Kick, Cross Chop. Is it Low Kick? Yay! Low Kick, Cross Chop! First go! So let's 91 IV, let's rename him. Okay, Primeape, 91, I did it again, cancel that, Primeape, 91, attacking 1, excellent, and CP is a little bit high for gym attacking and training. But that's alright, I can power him right up and he'll be a fantastic max IV, or like maximum, what am I saying? He'll just be a really good Pokemon. So let's name him Primeape. Whoa. Ape. 91, attacking 1. Alright, I've got 2 more goes now to get Low Kick, Low Sweep. And they're both 89 IVs, which is pretty decent. So let's evolve. Yes. Low Kick, Low Sweep. They're the ideal range. See what we get. Yes, I'm really looking forward to getting back to grinding. That's no good. And he's less than 90, so I'll just transfer it. Yes. And then on to this Mankey, 89. Evolve that one. If only there was training, because I'm sure there's some of you watching this video who would love to get your hands on some of my Pokemon that I'm just transferring off. Even though they don't have the best movesets, they're still high IVs. And if you don't play as much as I do, which is a lot, then you probably don't have this many good Low Kick, Low Sweep. Hey, I did it! That was awesome! I need to get some more Mankey candy to power them up. But I did got my Primeapes. Whoops, don't transfer. Rename. Oh, rename to nothing. Okay. So here's a Primeape. 89, and he's a defender at one. Fantastic. Add into the engineering spreadsheet. Primeape, 89, defender at one. Fantastic, Primeape done. Next Pokemon, ooh, I like this next one, Arcanine. I've got tons of really good Growlithe there. So I've got this Arcanine 98 IVs that I powered up before I was interested in movesets, and unfortunately, it's by Flamethrower, which isn't really, like, it's not the worst Pokemon, but it's not got the best moves. It's not A-grade moves. Same as this 91 IV one. Well, it's 91 IV, so I'm keeping it. I never powered it up. It was just really high to begin with. But, okay, what's the next one? We've got 93 Growlithe, and it, look at that CP to start. So this is going to be a monster. I've got tons of candies, so I could evolve them all. And that should be enough to get my two moves. I need two moves and I can do 10 power-ups. Or 9, I think, depending how many Growliths I had to power up. So Fire Fang, Fire Blast is preferable. Bite Flamethrower. It's a 93 IV, so I will keep it. And look at that CP, it's massive. Yeah, I'll keep it, but not what I wanted. So, well, next one, we'll do this. It's a monster too. This is going to be big. So let's evolve it. So it'll probably have over 1,000 CP after this evolution. And hopefully it's Fire Fang, Fire Blast, or Fire Fang, Flamethrower. Either way, I want Fire Fang. Come on, Fire Fang. Bite, Fire Blast. Well, it's got the moves. So let's, it's an 87 IV, so let's rename it. Oops, gotta delete the name first. Okay. And Arcanine. Rename 87, and it's a attacker 2. Attacker 2. Okay, and put it in here. Arcanine 87, attacker 2. Alright, with Bite Fire Blast. Yeah, it had over 2,000 CP as well, so got some pretty decent Arcanines now. I'll have to rename Growlithe 93 into Arcanine at some point, but let's keep going to get our movesets. Let's do this 87 IV one here to try and get something with Fire Fang to begin with. Evolve, yes. So, yeah, I don't have any Arcanines with Fire Fang. Hopefully this is the first one. Fire Fang. I wish I had Fire Fangs. Actually, I don't. But if I had a Growlithe and was going to make it grow up, Bite Bulldoze. That is nothing. You can be transferred right away. Yeah, if I had a Growlithe and was going to care for it and grow it up, I would hope that it had Fire Fangs when it got older. Let's see, what are we getting? What are we getting? Is this it? Fire Fang? No! Bite Flamethrower. That's not on the list, so you can go. Glad I had lots of them. Alright, it's less CP, but that might put it in the I think it'll still be above 1,200. But let's see what it is. It might get into the sweet spot for gyms, which is good if it's got Fire Fang Fire Blast. Yeah, certainly glad I had lots of these. It must be lots of combinations for the Arcanine because it just seems hard to get these Firefang flamethrower. Okay, there we go. We got another one. It's a defender. Growlithe 87. It's in the sweet spot too, which is a little unfortunate. It would have been perfect as an attacker, but we'll power it up and it'll be a good defender. Oops. So it's 87 IVs. Arcanine 87, and it is Defender 1. And added into my engineering spreadsheet, Arcanine 87, Defender 1. All right, one move set to go. And, ooh, which one should we choose? All right, it'll take some power, but let's choose my Growlithe 89. Best IVs, best for last. Let's get Firefang and Fire Blast now. I really hope that this is enough because I mean there was a Growlithe nest at KLCC and I just got so many good Growliths. I thought I had enough. I know, at that point, Firefang Bulldoze. Close, but no cigar. Transfer, yes. All right, one more go because I like to keep at least one Growlithe. So let's use this one here. Evolve, yes. At least I have tons of Growlithe candies, so that when I do get more Wonder Growliths eventually, I can evolve it straight away. All right. No, this will be it. Firefang, Fire Blast. Then I won't need more. Transfer. Oh, it's good. Look at that CP as well. Might keep that for now because what I found was as like in a place here where I'm taking so many gyms and holding on to them for so long, I was running out of good Pokemon to put in the gyms. So I may as well hold on to those Growliths. Especially here in Bansko, a lot of the Pokemon's in the gyms, like there's almost always a Lapras or some sort of ice Pokemon in there. So throw in a fire Pokemon as well and make that gym harder to take. If it is a full gym of ice Pokemon, I can use six Growliths and just smash it. Yeah. Oh, that's unfortunate. Oh well. Now, Poliwag, he evolves into Poliwrath. But I'm actually not going to do Poliwrath right now because I think there's a split evolution or something that might happen when slash if Gen 2 ever comes out. I think I'll give it maybe another 2 months. And if Gen 2 hasn't come out in 2 months, then I'll just do my evolutions for the Pokemon I'm waiting for. But now, Abra, Kadabra, Alakazam! So I've got one Alakazam there. Does it have any moves? No, it's not got anything exciting. But it's my only one at the moment. So I've got a couple. Here's a 93 IV Abra. All right. I don't know that I have enough. I don't have enough candy to do a full evolution, because that's takes 100 straight there. So I'll have to wait for Alakazam, get more Abras. Maybe I need to walk in Abra. That might be an option. I might be putting an Abra. My 93 Abra might become my buddy very soon. Next to Machop, Machoke, and Machamp. And that well, I haven't renamed it, but it doesn't have a decent moveset. But it's above 91, so I'm keeping it. And let's evolve. Let's see if I have enough candy. I do have enough for one evolution, so hopefully we get Karate Chop, Cross Chop. Yeah, I mean, I see like a few Machops around. Not a lot, but a few. So I've got a decent number of candy. But it just seemed like it was taking ages to get enough candy to, and or like a decent Machop as well to evolve. One more go. Karate Chop, Cross Chop is preferred. Otherwise, Bullet Submission, but preferably the attacker. Karate Chop, Cross Chop. What is he? What is he? Karate Chop, Stone Edge, which is nothing. Should I keep it? No, let's just get rid of it. It's not on the list. Transfer, yes. And I've got this one here, but I need a lot more Machop candy. Ooh, the next one is exciting for me. So I've found in the wild Bellsprout, Weepin' Bill, and Victory Bell. I found them all in the wild. So I've never done a Bellsprout evolution. So this is my first time doing any Bellsprout evolution. And I've got this massive 91 IV one. And look at my candy. There's tons of Bellsprout near where I live. So should get a good go. I want Razor Leaf Solar Beam. That would be preferred. It must have Razor Leaf as the first attack, and then otherwise evolve again. Otherwise, Razor Leaf Blade, or Razor Leaf Sludge Bomb to be a defender. But Razor Leaf Solar Beam would be good, so it can be a best really good attacker. All right, Razor Leaf at least. Razor Leaf, Razor Leaf. Razor Leaf Solar Beam, there we go. After some tough luck evolving, at least we get it straight up. So let's rename it. 91 IVs. Victory Bell. It's a 91 and it's an attacker. Nope, need to take out some letters. Victory Bull. 91, attacker 1. CP is a little bit high for to be right in the ideal range, so I might just have to power it up to be maximum 1. But low priority because there is certain scenarios where that could be ideal. So Victory Bull 91 A1. All right, I've got enough evolutions and enough good Bellsprouts that I should be able to get all three. So let's do this 89 here. Evolve, yes. Takes two evolutions. Oh, I forgot about that. So I probably don't have enough. It's 125 candy for like one full round of evolutions. So that was very lucky getting Razor Leaf Solar Beam straight up. One more go. Razor Leaf Sludge Bomb. Wonder if it'll keep that. That'd be alright. Razor Leaf Sludge Bomb, and then it can be my defender. Come on. Come on. Be the Pokemon I want. Be the Pokemon I want. Acid Sludge Bomb. Oh. Oh. All right. I might. It's two acid type moves or poison type moves, so I might keep it. No, I'll just get rid of it. Its CP is too high, and I'm not going to power that up, so transfer. Oh, here's the 90 IV one. Let's do that one. And hopefully, it has a good moveset because whatever it is, I'm keeping it. And its base CP was low enough to start that it's probably going to sit in the sweet spot for attacking, so hopefully it's a good attacker. Razor Leaf, Leaf Blade would be the ideal moveset. Ah, so I've been talking for about half an hour, and it's a decent amount of talking to keep you entertained or a little bit entertained while I evolve these Pokemon and engineer my spreadsheet of all these Pokemon. So we'll do a few more, and then I might end that episode. Resolief Sludge Bomb, it's a defender. Oh, yep, that's it. And its CP is tiny. Is it a baby? No. Oh, that was... Wow. I didn't realize the CP was so low. Wow. Alright. Well, it's 90 IVs, so let's clear that. And name it... Victory Bull. There we go. Victory Bull. 90. Defender 1. But I don't think it's going to defend much until I power it up. Victory Bull. 90. Defender 1. Alright. Well then, what's next? Let's use one that's, you know, a little higher than 65, 92. Alright, let's use this 87 Bellsprout and evolve that. Hopefully we get Razor Leaf Leaf Blade. Yeah, it takes a decent amount of time and battery power and recording space, recording on these three devices, to engineer my Pokemon to have everything that I want. Evolve again. So if you've caught every Pokemon out there, and then you've got like wonders of all these Pokemon, and you want to make the game last longer, you can engineer your Pokemon as well, make a spreadsheet and make a list of all the different Pokemon that you want, and then you have to evolve them. Acid Sludge Bomb again. It is in that sweet spot, so I might keep it for now, but I'll probably get rid of it later. Now here's the tough choice. I want an attacker, but I want a good one, so 88 is much better than 84, but Stardust is a commodity that's hard to come by. Tough choice. Alright, let's do the good one. 88. I'll leave the baby. Evolve, yes. Razor Leaf, Leaf Blade. And then if this one's no good, I'll evolve the higher CP one, but lower IV one next. But this one will be good. Razor Leaf, Leaf Blade. Leaf Blade. Say that 10 times fast. Razor Leaf, Leaf Blade. Only took me twice to stuff it up. Razor Leaf, Leaf Blade. Pokemon Tongue Twister. Alright. Be a good Pokemon. Razor Leaf, Sludge Bomb. Well, another defender with low CP. Let's add it to the list. It'll be a Victory Bull. It's a 88. Defender 1. Copy and add it to the spreadsheet. And rename it in my phone. Delete the name. And change the name. My phone's starting to go slow, so we might be nearing the end of this video. Victory. I'll take out some of those E's. Victory Bull. 88. D1. Razor Leaf Sludge Bomb. Alright, so we've got, yeah, I think this will probably be the last, yeah, this will be the last Pokemon evolution, and then I'll have to go get a bunch more candies, or last Bellsprout evolution, and hopefully, hopefully, Last Evolution is going to be the one I need. With Razor Leaf Leaf Blade, Razor Leaf Leaf Blade, Razor Leaf Leaf Blade, Razor Leaf Leaf Blade, Red Bull. yeah. That was hard. Comment Razor Leaf Leaf Blade if you're watching this. And, Razor Leaf Leaf Blade. Oh, Razor Leaf Solar Beam. Well, it's hard to be upset with an attacker that's the best. And it is sort of in that sweet spot range. So that can attack something that is 2,500 and something. Insert. Be a victory. Oh, wrong spot. Here we go. Be a Vic, struggling now, victory ball, and it is 84. It will be attacker one. Copy base values, renaming the phone back. Okay. So we're up to Pokemon ID number 71. So still plenty more Pokemon to evolve. Okay. Victory Ball. What was it? Oh, take out the E's. Victory Ball 84. Attacker 1. Okay, what's next? Alright, next we have Tentacool to Tentacruel. Again, this is another evolution that I've never done before. I've got this Tentacruel with Acid Sludge Wave, but I found that in the wild, so this will be my first evolution. So we'll do this 87 one. Yes, I've got enough candy so for a few. I don't have any of the decent moves for Tentacruel, so let's see. I've hatched quite a few Tentacruel, but for some reason they don't... Not Tentacruel, Tentacool, but they seem to be not wonders. So is it Poison Jab, Hydro Pump? Poison Jab, Blizzard. So he's the defender. That's okay. So see what we need to rename it. Have we got room? D... No, I gotta take out. Oh, I got. It's 87 IVs. So rename to nothing. And Tentacruel 87 defend. Nope. So we call it Tentacruel 87 defender. One. Oh no, it's actually Defender 2 because Poison Jab Hydro Pump is Defender Attacker 1 and cancel that. Attacker 1 and Defender 1. Rename Tentacruel Defender 2. Oh, and what IVs was it? It was like 87. Tentacruel 87 D1. I think that's what it was. Maybe it was 89. I think it was 89. Again, if you're watching this and I got that wrong, send me a comment so that I know to fix it, please. Thank you very much. Put that in here. Tent Cruel 89 Defender 2. Okay. And I can evolve another one. Let's do this one here. 83 IVs. Evolve. Yes. And we want Poison Jab, Hydro Pump. Preferably. And then it's 83, so if it's no good, I'll just delete it on the spot. Transfer some candy. What are you? But no, it'd be good. Poison Jar, Sludge Wave. Transfer. This next one will be what I want. Poison Jab, Hydro Pump. Evolve. Yes, I got two shots at Poison Jab, Hydro Pump. So hopefully that's it. But as you can see, I've still got plenty of high IV Pokemons to catch and hatch before I'll fin like properly finish the Pokemon Pocket. Poison Jab, Hydro Pump. Woo! Yes. Tenta Cruel missed this one. He is an 82, but attacker one, defender one. And we're gonna have to take out two letters. So it'll be Tentacruel. Tentacruel, A2, A1, D1. Oh, rename, delete the name. Okay, and then delete all these letters. Okay, so what did I call it? Tetcruel. Tet. Crew. Oh, crew. 80, 82. A1. D1. Okay. Poison Jab, Hydro Pump. Nice. That's fantastic. So there's my Tentacruels done. And I'm on a roll. So let's just keep it going. But I think this will be the last ones for this video. Else the videos can get too long and the processing will take forever. So look at all these high IVs Geodudes that I have. I've got tons of them. And I want some good golems. So let's see what's next. I've got this Geodude 89 already partially evolved. Oh, I don't have the candy. I can't do golem. Oh, I need more candy. All right, Ponita to Rapidash, and then you're the last one. So what do we have? We have a couple 90 IVs. So let's, and I don't know how much candy I've got. Oh, a decent amount. I can do seven, up to seven evolutions. So that should be good. I want Ember Fire Blast or Ember Drill Run. But hopefully I only need to do two evolutions of these 90 IV ones, and then I'm done. Ember for the attack, and then Fire Blast or Drill Run. So Ember Drill Run, there's my defender. So we'll rename that. Ponita 90. It's not a Ponita anymore. It's 93 IVs. So let's delete that. Rapidash 93. Defender 1. Perfect. Rapidash 93, Defender 1. And then, okay. Cool. Now I can get rid of this one with luck, and it's less than 90, so I can just get rid of it. Transfer. Now on to my 91 IV. Like I said, I only need to do two evolutions of this to get the two that I want. Evolve, yes, the last evolution, which will be Ember Fire Blast. And no, I haven't adjusted the editing to make it look like I knew what I would get, but I just know that this will be Ember Fire Blast. You see? You'll see. Ember Fire Blast. Ah! Ember Heat Wave. It's above, it's in sort of in that sweet spot, and it's above 90, so I'll keep it. Evolve, yes. Alright, I'm fairly certain that I can evolve. Out of all these evolutions, I will finish my Rapidash evolutions. And I'll get the movesets that I need. Alright, what's it gonna be? Ember Drillrun. We've got another defender. And it's 89, so Rapidash 89 D1. I wish it was 989, but it's not. There we go, and rename here in the phone to nothing to reset the name, and then rename again Rapidash 89 D1. Okay, and hopefully this is it, because it's 87 and that's a big drop from 87 to 84. So with a little bit of videotaping luck, this is Ember Fire Blast. Rapid Dash. Ember Fire Blast. Oh, I better fix this spreadsheet too with the moveset. There we are. Okay, Ember. Another Ember Drill Run. Lots of defenders. So let's just copy the name. But this one is an 87 IV. Copy, paste. An 87. So clear the name. What are the odds of getting that many with the best defending moveset? 87, defending 1. So we've got 3 defenders there, all with approximately the same IVs. On to the next one, evolve, yes. That's been exhausting, all the evolutions, and we've got tons more to go. The next one is Slowpoke, but again, that's a Gen 2 Pokemon. So we'll do the one, Low Kick Drill Run, that's nothing. So delete you. Ooh, this is my last one. Let's do the lower one. And evolve. I could, in theory, do both, except that I want to keep at least one of each Pokemon. So this is the last one. Hopefully, Ember Fire Blast. Hopefully. Oh, no, another delete. Transfer, yes. Oh, well. Well, that's this Pokemon. As I said, Slowpoke is the next one, but that has a Gen 2 evolution. So you'll have to tune in next time to the next Engineering Pokemon Go video to see how I go next. Catch you then.